Hello, everyone. I am Shih-Shinh Huang from National Kaohsiung University of Science and Technology, Taiwan. Today, I want to talk about FaceNet, which is a deep network for face feature iteration. FaceNet was published in the paper entitled as FaceNet, a Unified Embedding for Face Recognition and Clustering on CVPR 2015. The outline of this lecture includes introduction about motivation and the idea of FaceNet and the benefits of using FaceNet, Euclidean Embedding about the FaceNet architecture for mapping a face image to a high-dimensional Euclidean space, and the loss function called the Triplet Loss for training FaceNet architecture. Triplet selection about motivation to select triplets for training, and the two selection strategies, including intuitive selection and online generation. Previous methods for face recognition is firstly to collect lots of faces of persons to be recognized. For example, to recognize me, Paul, and my wife, TTJ, the first step is to collect our faces. By using the collected face data set, a process called the training is then applied to learn a recognizer that can successfully recognize Paul and TTJ. 2 years ago, our family has a new member, my daughter Miao. In order to recognize all members, we have to collect and add Miao faces to the dataset. Then, we retrain the model to make it able to recognize me, my wife, and my daughter. Accordingly, the previous recognition methods generally suffer two problems. Firstly, the cost of retraining is high and is sometimes not affordable, especially in the case of that the number of persons to be recognized is large. Secondly, collecting sufficient faces to train a good classifier is impractical in some applications. Prior to detail the idea of FaceNet, we firstly gain an insight into previous face recognition. In general, a face recognizer consists of feature iteration and the classification stages. The feature iteration stage is to describe a face in a discriminative way. For classification stage, it assigns an identifier to a face according to the extracted features. In deep learning area, a convolution neural network is generally used for feature iteration, and a fully connected network is for face classification. The main idea of FaceNet is to decouple feature iteration and the face classification stages. In other words, the proposed FaceNet is a CNN just for feature iteration, but not for classification. Furthermore, the objective of FaceNet is to extract face features so that the learning of FaceNet is independent of persons to be recognized. Therefore, the FaceNet can be trained once by using currently existing face datasets. Based on the features provided by FaceNet, the face classification can be achieved by using the simple and training-free algorithm. For example, the classification of a face can be achieved by mapping it to the FaceNet feature space and then applying nearest neighborhood strategy. In short, the using of FaceNet has two benefits. Firstly, since the FaceNet is a feature descriptor, Its training is independent of persons to be recognized, and only shared face datasets can be used for training. The trained FaceNet is applicable to any other face applications without retraining. Secondly, since FaceNet can provide discriminative face features, the use of FaceNet makes face-related tasks straightforward and without training. For example, the face verification problem becomes thresholding. If the input face has the distance less than a threshold DTH to template face, it is polled. Otherwise, it is not polled. For classification problem, the input face is classified as the one with the smallest distance. By using these simple and training-free strategies, the number of faces necessary for face-related tasks becomes small. The proposed FaceNet is a kind of Euclidean embedding function, which maps a face clip to a Euclidean space so that layer similarity can be measured. For example, if a FaceNet maps a face to a two-dimensional Euclidean space whose horizontal axis is hair length and the vertical axis is skin color, then the faces after embedding by FaceNet are the points in two-dimensional Euclidean space. The distance between these two points can be calculated as this equation. More specifically, the FaceNet maps a face X to a d-dimensional unit vector, TOS1, TOS2, to TOSD. The length of f of x is 1.0. The first step of FaceNet is to use a deep CNN to perform Euclidean embedding that maps x to a d-dimensional feature vector. The second step uses L2 norm to constrain embedding to the d-dimensional surface of hypersphere. That is, max f of x has a length equal to 1.0. The purpose of step 2 is to make the embedding invariant to lighting variance or affine transformations. The network used in FaceNet for Euclidean embedding can be any types of deep CNNs. In this paper, style network and the inception type network are used for discussion. Here are their references respectively. As discussed in this paper, FaceNet achieves its best performance when D is set to 128. The objective of FaceNet is to provide discriminative embedding. This means that faces of the same person after embedding should have small distance, and the faces of distinct persons after embedding should have large distance. To achieve this, a loss function called the triplet loss is introduced to train the FaceNet in this paper. Unlike the loss function, such as cross entropy loss defined in the class level, the triplet loss is directly defined in the embedding feature space. Therefore, its training is independent of faces to be recognized. It can be trained by using off-the-shelf face datasets and applicable to any other face applications without retraining. Triplet loss models embedding discriminability on a triplet, SA, SP, and SN, where SA is an anchor image of a specific person. SP is a positive image of the same person to anchor image. SN is a negative image of any other person. A good embedding to a triplet means that the Euclidean space determined by FaceNet makes the distance between anchor and the positive small, and the length between anchor and the negative large. The distance used here is the Euclidean distance. Accordingly, the triplet loss is defined as this equation. The idea behind is that the distance between anchor and the negative must larger than the distance between anchor and the positive, at least a constant value called the margin alpha. Otherwise, a penalty is added. In the left case, negative is far enough from anchor, so the distance between anchor and the positive plus alpha is less than the distance between anchor and the negative. Therefore, the loss is equal to zero. In the right case, negative is close to anchor and we add the penalty equal to the length of red segment. The total loss for training FaceNet is defined as sum over all triplets, where T is the set of all possible triplets. In other words, training FaceNet is to find an embedding Euclidean space so as to minimize the distance between anchor and the positive, and maximize the distance between anchor and the negative. However, using all possible triplets for training FaceNet leads to slow convergence. This is because there are many easy triplets that are easily satisfied and without contributing to the training. This picture shows an example of an easy triplet. In this triplet, the positive and the negative can be easily distinguished. It means that the distance from the anchor to negative is much larger than the one from anchor to positive. To address this issue, this paper selects the hard examples for training to ensure phase convergence. The hard triplet, as shown in this picture, is that the distance from the anchor to negative is close to the one from anchor to positive. The intuitive way to select hard triplet is by finding the hardest positive S hat P and the negative S hat N to an anchor SA. Here gives the definitions of the hardest positive and the negative respectively. For an anchor SA, its hardest positive is the one among positives and with the largest distance. The hardest negative is the one among negatives and with the smallest distance. Selecting hard triplet in this way will lead to poor training because poorly imaged face will dominate the selection of the hardest positive and negative. To solve the problem of intuitive selection, this paper used the online generation strategy. The first step is to sample training dataset to generate a mini patch around 1,800 faces, containing about 40 faces per identity, and randomly sample the negatives. The second step is to form all possible triplets within the mini patch. It uses all anchor positive pairs, followed by taking a semi-hard negative to each anchor positive pair. Semi-hard negatives are the negatives within the margin area. To more detail, for a training data set, we sample it to obtain a mini patch with around 1,800 faces. Then, for any anchor positive pair within the mini patch, We embed the name to Euclidean space determined by FaceNet and select a semi-hard negative to form a triplet. Semi-hard negatives are all negatives in mini-patch and embedded to margin region by FaceNet. In this example, these two faces are coded semi-hard negatives. Among these semi-hard negatives, we randomly select one as negative to form a triplet. In this lecture, we introduce a deep CNN coded FaceNet for providing discriminative face features. The proposed triplet loss makes the training of FaceNet in feature level, and the trained FaceNet can be applicable to other applications without retraining. In addition, this paper used the online generation strategy to select hard triplets for fast convergence in training. Thanks for your listening and have a nice day.